بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الحمد لله رب العالمين، والصلاة والسلام على رسوله الكريم. أما بعد، فأعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. ثاني اثنين إذ هما في الغار إذ يقول لصاحبه لا تحزن إن الله معنا. صدق الله العظيم. إن الله وملائكته يصلون على النبي. يا أيها الذين آمنوا صلوا عليه وسلموا تسليما. الصلاة والسلام عليك يا سيدي يا رسول الله وعلى آلك وأصحابك يا سيدي يا حبيب الله. All praise, glory, honor belongs to Allah Ta'ala and His peace, blessings upon our Master sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, His companions, His wives, His family, all of the righteous awliya, shuhada, and rightly guided ulama of Ahl Sunnati wal Jama'ah. The verse from Al-Quran Al-Kareem I've recited was revealed in regards to the best of mankind after the prophets and messengers alayhim wa salatu wa salam. My and your master Sayyidina Abu Bakr as-Siddiq radiallahu ta'ala anhu. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentions the incident when in Ghari Thawr Rasulullah alayhi salatu wa salam was traveling, making hijrah from Makkah to al-Mukarramah to Medina to al-Munawwara, and he stayed in the cave with Sayyidina Siddiq Akbar radiallahu ta'ala anhu. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentions ثاني اثنين إذ هما في الغار, when the second of the two, when both of them were in the cave, إذ يقول لصاحبه, when he said to his sahib, his companion, when the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said to Sayyidina Abu Bakr Siddiq radiallahu ta'ala anhu, لا تحزن إن الله معنا, that do not worry, indeed Allah is with us. So there were just three there. There was Sayyidina Abu Bakr Siddiq radiallahu anhu, there was with him Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam told him that with us is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Sayyidina Siddiq Akbar radiallahu ta'ala anhu, from this verse, his sahabiyat companionship is established. And this is established with qat'iyat, with absoluteness, such that if anyone denies and says that he is not a sahabi, then that person falls outside the fold of Islam, becomes a kafir. Because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is explicitly using the word sahib here. So he is the companion of the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, as we call him Yare Ghare Mustafa, and he is also Yare Mizare Mustafa. That not only is he the companion of the cave, but today he is also the companion of the grave. That the closest of all mankind to the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam right now as we speak, lying next to him in Rawza Sharif, is Sayyidina Siddiq Akbar radiallahu anhu. And then next to him is Sayyidina Farooq Azam radiallahu anhu. And then a bit away near Rasulullah alayhi salatu wasalam, there is an empty space which has been vacated and which has been readied for the second coming of Sayyidina Isa alayhi salatu wasalam, and that he shall be buried in that maqam under the green dome of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wa sallam. Sayyidina Siddiq Akbar radiallahu ta'ala anhu, about him our aqidah is clear. Nabi alayhi salatu wasalam mentions مَا طَلَعَتِ الشَّمْسُ وَلَا غَرَبَتْ عَلَىٰ أَحَدٍ أَفْضَلَ مِنْ أَبِي بَكْرٍ إِلَّا أَنْ يَكُونَ نَبِيًّا, that the sun has neither risen nor has it set over anyone better than Sayyidina Abu Bakr Siddiq radiallahu ta'ala anhu, except for the prophets. Except for the prophets, meaning that after all the prophets alayhi wassalatu wassalam, no man is greater than Sayyidina Abu Bakr Siddiq radiallahu ta'ala anhu. In another narration, the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam mentions Abu Bakrin khayrun nasi illa an yakuna nabiyan, that Abu Bakr is the best of mankind unless it is one of the prophets. So Abu Bakr Siddiq radiallahu anhu is the best of all mankind unless the person is a prophet, then Siddiq Akbar radiallahu ta'ala anhu does not have superiority over them. And sometimes People doubt this aqeedah. And commonly this is happening amongst so-called Sunnis today, that they are denying the superiority of Sayyidina Abu Bakr Siddiq radiallahu ta'ala anhu, and they are saying Ali da pehla number. Yani Ali da pehla number, ye aqeedah jo hai, Sunniyon ka aqeedah nahi. Mere aur aapki aqa sallallahu alayhi wa sallam ka aqeedah nahi. Sahaba ka aqeedah nahi. Arey Mawla Ali Shere Khuda, unka khud, unka aqeedah ye nahi hai. Why? This is not even the belief of Sayyidina Mawla Ali Shere Khuda radiallahu ta'ala anhu, because he mentions himself. He says, خَيْرُ هَذِهِ الْأُمَّةِ بَعْدَ نَبِيِّهَا أَبُو بَكْرٍ ثُمَّ عُمَرٍ. That Sayyidina Ali radiallahu anhu mentions himself. He says, the best of this ummah after our Nabi, after its Nabi, is Abu Bakr and then Umar radiallahu anhuma. So this makes it absolutely clear that when the aqidah of Sayyidina Ali radiallahu anhu himself is that the best of this ummah is Siddiq and Farooq, then someone who comes forward and says, no, let's try to reverse this order and let's start saying Ali is first. This belief essentially stems from the Shia creed. Why? Because the Shia believe him to be superior, and then they also believed him to be the rightful Khalifa. The Shia believe that the first three Khalifas, Sayyidina Abu Bakr, Sayyidina Umar, Sayyidina Uthman radiallahu anhum, that they deprived Sayyidina Ali radiallahu anhu of the right of leadership. This is their false and batil aqidah. Why is this false and batil? Because the Sahaba, the Muhajirun and the Ansar, all the companions of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, gathered behind Sayyidina Abu Bakr Siddiq radiallahu anhu. Including who? Including Mawla Ali, Imam Hassan, Imam Hussain radiallahu anhu. Then when the time of Sayyidina Umar radiallahu anhu came, again, all the Sahaba, the Ahlul Bayt, united behind the Khilafat of Sayyidina Umar al-Faruq radiallahu anhu. And similarly, in the time of Hazrat Uthman Ghani radiallahu anhu. So when this is the case, that they accepted the leadership of the first three caliphs, for somebody to come forward now and try to say, no, it should have been Ali who was first, then such an individual is doubting the entire companions of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and he is someone who is wanting the destruction of Islam, and he's wanting the damaging of Islam, because with such an aqidah, with such a belief that the first three khalifas have robbed the fourth one of his right, such a belief means that the companions were unjust, that they were wrongdoers, that they acted wrongly, that they were fusaq, and that they were zalim. If a person has this aqidah, then we reply to this, we say, who gave us Al-Quran Al-Kareem? And who told us about Hadith Sharif? It was none other than Sahaba of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So if Sahaba of Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam were unjust and were wrongdoers, then what will become of the Holy Quran which you're reading today? How can that be reliable? Do you understand my point, the logic? And how can the hadith and how can all the rulings of Islam and the entire deen be reliable if the first generation of companions were so bad and wrong? So this tells us, necessitates that this is incorrect, because logically we know that the Sahaba were the best of people, and this cannot possibly be correct that they were all unjust and wrong. If they become unjust and wrong, then the Holy Quran, na'uzu billah, becomes wrong. Because different parts of the Holy Quran were narrated through different companions. Different companions gave us different parts and verses and ahadith and parts of this deen. If the companion becomes unjust, that part of the deen also becomes wrong. So, Nabi alayhi salatu wasalam, all his companions, he mentions, ashabi kan nujum. بِأَيِّهِمْ اِكْتَدَيْتُمْ اِهْتَدَيْتُمْ. That my companions are guiding stars. Whichever one you follow, you shall be guided. So Sayyidina Ali Shere Khuda radiallahu ta'ala anhu, he made this clear, and his son Hazrat Muhammad ibn al-Hanafiyya radiallahu anhu narrates this from his father, from Sayyidina Ali radiallahu anhu, regarding this, and that the best of people after The Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, Abu Bakr and Umar. Nabi alayhi salatu wa salam, he has mentioned many great qualities of Siddiq Akbar radiallahu anhu. One of the greatest qualities is when he mentions, مَا نَفَعَنِي مَالُ أَحَدٍ قَبْتُ مَا نَفَعَنِي مَالُ أَبِي بَكْرٍ رَضِيُ اللَّهُ عَنْهُ. That the wealth of nobody has ever benefited me as much as the wealth of Sayyidina Abu Bakr Siddiq radiallahu anhu. And Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam once said to Sayyidina Siddiq Akbar radiallahu ta'ala anhu, that أَنْتَ صَاحِبِي فِي الْغَارِ وَصَاحِبِي عَلَى الْحَوْدِ. That you are my companion in the cave, and you are my companion upon the house of Kawthar. On the day of judgment, Nabi alayhi salatu wasalam, he will be with him. And Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasalam mentions to him, أَنْتَ عَتِيقُ اللَّهِ مِنَ النَّارِ. That you are atiq from the hellfire, meaning you are the one who is freed from hellfire. This point about him being free from hellfire, we need to go back to the Holy Quran and see what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala himself says in Surah Al-Layl. Surah Al-Layl, Allah ta'ala mentions, وَسَيُجَنَّبُهَا الْأَتْقَى. Allah says, and far removed from the hellfire will be Al-Atqa, the most pious one. This is Ism Tafdil in Arabic grammar, the superlative noun, which denotes superiority. That the most pious person, like we say, Kabir is great, but who is Akbar? Greatest. Okay? So similarly, like a Taqi would be a pious one, but what will be Al-Atqa, most pious one? Allah is saying, Al-Atqa, وَسَيُجَنَّبُهَا الْأَتْقَى. The most pious one is far removed from hellfire. الَّذِي يُؤْتِي مَا لَهُ يَتَزَكَّى. The one who gave his wealth to purify himself. Right? وَمَا لِأَحَدٍ عِنْدَهُ مِنْ نِعْمَةٍ تُجْزَى. And there is no favor. You know, nobody has to repay him. There is no favor of his which has to be repaid. Okay? So Sayyidina Abu Bakr Siddiq radiallahu ta'ala anhu is being referred to in these verses in the Holy Quran. Imam Fakhruddin Razi rahimahullah mentions in his Tafsir al-Kabir under this verse, he says, that he mentions that أَجْمَعَ الْمُفَسِّرُونَ مِنَّا. That there is ijma', unanimous agreement of the commentators of the Quran, مِنَّا, from us. Who are we? أَهْلِ سُنَّةِ وَالْجَمَاعَةِ. That from our Sunni commentators of Quran, there is unanimous agreement that this verse, these verses apply to Sayyidina Abu Bakr Siddiq radiallahu ta'ala. And then he says that the Shia believe that this verse applies to Sayyidina Ali. But then he dismisses it and says why it is wrong. Why is this wrong? He says, because the following verse which is mentioned, وَمَا لِأَحَدٍ عِنْدَهُ مِنْ نِعْمَةٍ تُجَزَى. That there is no favor which is owed to him by anyone. Sorry, that he does not owe a favor to anyone which has to be repaid. He says, Imam Razi says, if you look at the case of Sayyidina Ali radiallahu ta'ala anhu, it's different. Sayyidina Ali radiallahu anhu, he owes many favors to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Why? Because he was a young boy and Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam nurtured him. He cared for him. He gave him clothes. He gave him food. He brought him up with love and affection and did all these favors to him. Whereas the point of Siddiq Akbar radiallahu anhu was the opposite. And Rasulullah ﷺ gave his daughter Fatima to Ali. But with Siddiq Akbar radiallahu anhu. Siddiq Akbar radiallahu anhu, he gave all his wealth for the sake of Rasulullah ﷺ. He sacrificed everything for Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. All of his wealth. That Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is saying that the wealth of no one has benefited me as much as the wealth of Abu Bakr. So he makes it clear. And Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was given the blessed daughter Aisha in marriage of Sayyidina Siddiq Akbar radiallahu ta'ala anhu. So this verse clearly applies, وَسَيُجَنَّبُهَا الْأَتْقَى, to Sayyidina Abu Bakr Siddiq radiallahu ta'ala anhu. And then if we look in another verse of Al-Quran Al-Kareem, إِنَّ أَكْرَمَكُمْ عِنْدَ اللَّهِ أَتْقَاكُمْ. Allah Azza wa Jalla states in another maqam of the Holy Quran in Surah Hujurat that indeed the most honorable of you is the one who is the most pious of you. That the honorable one, the most honorable, is the one who is the most pious. Imam Sayyid Sharif al-Jurjani rahimahullah, in his Sharh al-Mawaqif, he mentions these verses. And he says, in order to understand them, we take both of these verses together. In one verse in the 30th juz, Allah is saying that the most pious one is furthest from hellfire. The most pious one is furthest from hellfire. We say that is referring to Sayyidina Siddiq Akbar radiallahu ta'ala anhu. In the other verse, Allah is saying, the best of you, the most honorable of you, is the one who is the most pious. So when you take these two verses together, you understand from Al-Quran Al-Kareem that the best one of you, the most pious one of you, is none other than our master, Sayyidina Abu Bakr Siddiq radiallahu ta'ala anhu. And Imam Jurjani was an Imam of Aqidah, and he was Sayyid as well. He was from the family of Rasulullah alayhi salatu wasalam, and he mentions this in his book as well, that the Aqidah of Ahlul Sunnah is the best of mankind after the prophets is Sayyidina Abu Bakr Siddiq radiallahu ta'ala anhu. And he says that the Shia, they believe the best is Sayyidina Ali. But the belief of Ahlul Sunnah wal Jama'ah is clear, as Imam Al-Azim Abu Hanifa radiallahu ta'ala anhu made it, that خير الناس بعد نبيها خير الناس بعد نبينا عليه الصلاة والسلام أبو بكر ثم عمر ثم عثمان ثم علي رضي الله عنهم أجمعين. That the best of people after the prophet, after our prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم, and after all the prophets, meaning after our Nabi صلى الله عليه وسلم, in our ummah, who was the best of people? First Abu Bakr, then Umar, then Uthman, and then Ali رضي الله عنهم. In that chronological order, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give us true love of all the Sahaba. Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, finally, he mentions, حُبُّ أَبِي بَكْرٍ وَشُكْرُهُ وَاجِبٌ عَلَىٰ كُلِّ أُمَّتِي. That the love of Abu Bakr and thanking him is wajib upon every single ummati of time.
Subhanallah.
Siddiq Akbar radiallahu ta'ala anhu, afzalul bashar ba'da al-anbiya. As I mentioned the previous week, there's two books, inshallah, today which are available outside after Jum'ah. Both of them just for £5. Two for £5. Very simple books are translated into English. And these books are very important in Creed. The first one I have here, The Reality of Lineage, Haqiqat al-Nasab. This is about Sadat-e-Kiram and the honor of Sayyids, that they are superior to non-Sayyids. This book details this and explains why from Quran and Hadith, and then mentions a few other points regarding Sadat-e-Kiram, objections and answers. Very important book for everyone to have to understand the maqam of Ahlul Bayt and the maqam of noble Sayyids from the family of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. This book is by Mufti Ahmad Yar Khan alayhi rahma. The second book, Kitab al-Aqaid by Sadr al-Ufadil Sayyid Na'imuddin Muradabadi alayhi rahma. This book on basic beliefs on Aqaid, if I quickly just run through the contents, talks about Allah, His prophets, His books, His angels, Judgment Day, destiny, life after death, paradise and hell, some signs of Judgment Day, and mentions about Dajjal, beast of the earth, Ya'juj Ma'juj, Imam Mahdi, Hazrat Isa alayhi salam returning, rising of the sun from the west, and then it mentions about the Sahaba, the rightly guided caliphs, about imamat, leadership in Islam, and awliya Allah. All these things are discussed in this book, and it's very basic, both of them. And they're only two for £5. I urge everyone to take these books as you leave the masjid and give them to your children to read. And indeed, those who need more copies, do order more copies. We have gatherings of Isal-e-Thawab. I suggest the best Isal-e-Thawab rather than give people food, because we've all had enough food, I think. We are well fed and well looked after. We should feed our souls with knowledge and with the true legacy of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. A great way of doing Isal-e-Thawab is to buy these books and distribute them. And the knowledge will continuously be sadaqah jariyah for the deceased. وَمَا عَلَيْنَا إِلَّا الْبَلَاغُ الْمُبِينَ